Hey everyone, welcome to Plants and Politics. So there's a few developments with Democrat Cal Cunningham, who is running to unseat Republican Tom Tillis in North Carolina. And up until recently, Cunningham had a small lead over Tillis. Tillis is out with coronavirus. So this district is just a mess right now, but Cal Cunningham was recently caught in a scandal when text messages had been discovered between Cunningham and a woman named Arlene Guzman Todd. She's a public relations strategist, and both of them are married. So both Cunningham and Guzman Todd are married. And originally, the text messages that came out just talked about how they wanted to get together and kiss. It was all kind of middle school type of salacious. It didn't indicate that he was actually having an affair. Well, now new messages have come to light. And it appears that, yes, they were having a full-blown affair. So there were messages from Guzman Todd to a friend of hers where she said, "I just want to blank him one last time and break his heart." I'm saying blank. As you guys know, I cuss on the show, but I'm saying blank because they don't say what it is. I'm assuming it's the F word. It just says expletive. The other statement she made via text to her friend said, "Trying to make plans to see the politician so I can give him the blank of his life and then walk away." So again, I'm assuming it's the F word. I don't know. It could be some other sexual favor. I don't know. But yeah, this is really, really gross. When news reporters reached out to Guzman Todd, she did not respond to some, but she did speak with AP reporters, Associated Press reporters, and she told them that she had two encounters with Cunningham. One was non-sexual in nature. They were not intimate with each other in that March encounter. The other, however, occurred in July, and they were intimate at that time. She complained to a friend also via text messages that Cunningham wasn't contacting her anymore. She said that he used to contact her every day and essentially he kind of ditched her. So she joked about how she could ruin his career if she wanted to. And she joked about sending naked photos of him to his opponent, Tom Tillis. She also made jokes about Cunningham's wife, and she just really seems like a horrible person all the way around. So Tom Tillis put out a statement, which I find to be so unbelievably hypocritical and ridiculous. Tillis said, quote, "I'm sad for his wife and his teenage children. Cal Cunningham owes everybody an explanation for two revelations over the past week." Really? Really, Tom Tillis, you are a member of the party that supports Donald J. Trump. Donald J. Trump, who has cheated on every wife he has ever had. Donald J. Trump, who, it came out, paid hush money to a porn star and a Playboy model because he had had sex with both of them, including the porn star who he allegedly slept with without protection and while his wife was pregnant or had just given birth, I forget which one, to Barron, and was home taking care of their child. Really? Oh, you're so sad. You're so disturbed for his wife and his children. Are you serious? I mean, yeah, do I think this is outrageous and disgusting? Absolutely. Do I think that Cunningham has shown a lack of character, that he is not to be trusted, that he's immoral? Absolutely. Absolutely. That is not someone I would vote for. I'm sorry, but I know some people can separate your morality, your ethics, your character from politics. I believe they go hand in hand. If you cannot be honest with your spouse, with the person who gave you children, who bore your children, I'm sorry. No, you don't have the character to be a leader, to be an ethical representative. Sorry, it's the way it is. You may disagree. That's what I think. But come on, Republicans. Really? Republicans lost any right to the moral high ground, any right to speak on the character or morality of anyone, anyone on this planet after electing and supporting and covering for and defending and protecting Donald Trump for the last 4 years. It is laughable for these people to speak out and feign, oh, clutch their pearls and feign moral outrage and concern. Give me a break. Was he concerned for Melania? Did he say, I'm so sad for his wife and his young child, Barron? No, not a word. Not a freaking word when it came out about Stormy Daniels. So give me a break, Tom Tillis. Just sit all the way down. Ugh, so sick of the hypocrisy. So anyway, who knows? You know, right now with the state of our politics, the state of our country, probably won't make a bit of difference. It probably will not matter one bit. It's not going to change the calculation in anyone's mind. And that is sad. That is the really sad state of affairs that we find ourselves in when morality and character don't matter. They don't factor into the equation. And it's all about what team you're on, what letter you have behind your name, and whether or not our side is going to win and the other side is going to lose. And that goes both ways. That goes for both sides of the aisle. It's disgusting. I don't know what we're devolving into, but it's not good, guys. This is a slippery slope. So, as always, like, share, subscribe. I will talk to you guys soon. Take care. Thanks for listening to Plants and Politics. The only way we can take our country and power back is to spread the truth and build an army. So remember to like, follow, subscribe, and share on Facebook, YouTube, and wherever you listen to your podcasts. Thanks again.